Hi guys, it's me, Ellen from The Winding Leaf, and welcome to part 2 of the October-November house plan tour and growing update. Enjoy! So let's start the second part of my tour with a plan that I don't show you a lot because there are so many other plans, you know, it is what it is. It's a very nice Calathea Trio Star. I must say it's the only Calathea I have that doesn't have any big problems. It just stands here. Some leaves come out a little bit crusty, but overall it does its thing. No pests or nothing, no welting. So I'm very happy with this one. Then let me show you an update on my Monstera stand Liliana. You know, I told you, we can see that for the longest time nothing happened, and then she started to push out 4 variegated, heavily variegated leaves at once, and it took like, I'm not kidding, 2 months for them to like unfurl. And you see they're not even completely unfurled even now, but she did not stop there. She just kept producing one after the other, as you can see here. Yeah, I mean, what can you do? This is one strand, so one plant that produces all of this. The other ones that are on this, mounted on this pole, like produce more normal looking green leaves that have little specks in them. But this one, really, this strand is really like the hardcore variegated one. That's why she's directly in front of the window, so she gets lots of light to help her along and produce enough chlorophyll to sustain all of this. This is the reason, you know, those leaves are so wide that it takes a long time for the plant to do anything with that. So, but you know, we are not in a rush. It's not a sprint, it's a marathon. Yeah, my other plants that are in this corner, I show you in my next video when I talk about all the plants I put on poles or on the wall to let the leaves grow and how I did it and stuff like that. So we'll look at it next time. And for now, we go into my bedroom. But you know what? Before we do that, let me show you this little, not so little anymore, Rapidophora Theta Sperma that I put on this IKEA lamp. So we have light and a pole to trail on and also to reach the ceiling possibly. I hope it does, and I hope it then attaches itself or does cool looking things with the ceiling. We will see. And you can't see it right now, but the last 2 leaves, one of those strands produced, were like unfenestrated, and I had never seen an unfenestrated leaf on a Rapidophora before. So maybe it's like majority growth reversed or something like that. Yeah, and let me show you this cool little thing. I got it for my birthday from my friend. It's like out of a fire extinguisher and some, you know, thingy. It's like a vase, or you can also put a plant in it, like use it as a cash pot. We will see. Very pretty. Yeah, and here, you know, my Obofolia. I mean, you remember videos from a year ago, it looked like the most amazing plant ever, and then all the leaf started to drop, but didn't die. So I put it outside so that I don't have to look at the drama and my failure. And it didn't do anything. It didn't produce new leaves. The leaves didn't die. It just stayed like this. So when I brought her in, I cut off all the crunchy parts, trimmed her down radically, put her here, and we will see what happens. So, I don't know. Yeah, here with Thaumatophyllum Selum Hope. If you have a big space in your house and want a real jungle feeling, it also looks good with cats next to it, then I can recommend this plant for you, because it's real bushy and nice looking, but you need a lot of space. So otherwise it is just squished in a corner. It's not looking nice. And I put my Monstera here. She was before between the windows, but I put her here because she started growing so circular that I didn't want to squish her, you know, against walls and deal with where to put this leaf and stuff like that. So I put her here for now and have those two grow lights more or less, you know, giving additional light so we can produce those nice and mature fenestrated leaves. And I have two on this plant. We have, here is one. You know, this is what you want. You want leaves that all that not just have this fenestration, but also start having it here in the middle. And this plant has two of those already, quite tiny yet. You know, normally they get very big, but we all have to start somewhere. Yeah, and here we have it. This is a Dracaena. I forgot the name of it, Mike or something like that. And then we have my two Marantas. And the light green Maranta, for some reason, had like, now last 3 weeks she produced lots of, also she didn't produce, but lots of the leaves started to crumble up and turn yellow, and I did not change anything with watering, or I don't know, maybe just was, you know, she had like also Corona or something, I don't know. I cut them off and I hope it's over now with this problem. All right, but now we go into my bedroom and have a look there. So here we are, and as you can see, my Anthurium clarinervum already started to produce another spatu, whatever thingy whatsy, where the seams will be for some reason. So I got one leaf, and then again she's starting to produce seeds. So nobody needs that. I have enough baby plants, like at least like 20. But what can you do with this plant? It is what it is. Yeah, this is a Rapidophora, a name I forgot right now, that is supposed to attach to this like wood and then shingle. We will see how that goes. So yeah, I keep you posted on that. Yeah, my bed is unmade. What can you do? Anyway, Homalomena, huge plant, could even use a bigger pot, but I mean, space, people, space, you know? And it has really big leaves that like try and reach the window and the source of light, because it's a quite a dark room. It has two, also those two windows. If the sun is shining, we have enough light. If not, it's dingy and gloomy in here, or quite kuschelig, like snuggly. Anyway, so what do we have here? My philodendron mamii that like really is trying me. So if you watched a couple of my videos, you might know that this plant really, you know, leaves are like crumbling up for no reason whatsoever. This unfurling is still not done. It's at least 2 months. Since 2 months, this, or even longer, this tries to make something happen. I don't know what. I mean, another leaf also is in this state for at least 4 weeks. So, and the humidity here right now is 45, but normally it's between 60 and 70. So, you know, it is what it is. But my philodendron Burl Marx, I can really highly recommend this plant. Also, it's not so expensive anymore. It's like 25-ish euros. Or dollars, really is an avid grower. So this is a really nice plant if you want to see something happen. So, or find a nice pot and get yourself a very nice looking heart-shaped leaf philodendron. It also will give you lots of joy. And then I have a new begonia, but I don't know the name of it right now. It grows a little bit, it's a cane begonia, so it grows tall, and the leaves have a very nice sheen to it. It's a little bit hard to see with this light, but in the future I will show you updates of this plant. And here my Calithia rufibarbia that, you know, all the long, amazing looking leaves and stems started to droop. The same with as the obofolia at the beginning of spring. So I cut everything back, put her outside, and thought, if you die, then you die. Otherwise, let's see what happens. And she's pushed out lots of new growth. So we will see if she grows back. And same with the ornata. She had pests and I tried everything and yeah, whatever. So I also like put her outside and see, you know, before I schlep you to the trash bin. And then for some reason she didn't die and she started to get new leaves. So she gets a new chance. Yeah, Lauterbachia also lost all its leaf, but this is normal dormancy from alocasia. And she got new leaves and baby leaves and all is peachy with this plant. So if you have a big, tall, mature exemplar and then starts to lose all its leaves, don't panic, it will grow back. And sorry, it's Pedro yelling in the background, my cat. And this is a new plant I have. And now I forgot what it's called. It's a epipremnum something. Amplissi, whatever, I don't know. Yeah, got it from in the Netherlands for like 15 euros or something. Was already this tall. Silver strike something something. Something rather than, for sure it's an epipremnum. Yeah, because I like epipremnums. It looks like an avid grower, so I hope it trails away over this whole shelf in not too long. And let's see. Pedro, what's your problem? Huh? Schnecki, was? What's happening? It's his very active 5 minutes where he runs like a crazy person through the whole house. Alrighty. In the unmade bed. What can you do? It is what it is. This is real life. This authentic YouTube life. Do you want to say hello to the people? No. Okay. All right. Wonderful. Alrighty. I would say with this, Pedro and I leave you for now and wish you a very nice afternoon. And I see you next time. Bye-bye.